Hello students, myself Professor Ambika Devi, Assistant Professor of Physics, Government First Grade College, Bidar. Today's video is related to Session 53 of BSc 5th Sem Solid State Physics course and which is prescribed in the colleges affiliated to Karnataka State Gulbarga University, Kalburgi. So let us now begin with the session that is related to Introduction to Superconductivity. So, students, in this section, we will discuss about the superconductivity, introduction about the superconductivity. Superconductivity is the phenomena which was first observed by Dutch physicist H.K. Ohms in the year 1911. Okay. Superconductivity was first discovered, first it was observed by the scientist H.K. Ohms in the year 1911. In the course of his experiments on the electrical conductivities of metal at low temperature, during the experiments of electrical conductivities of metals in low temperature, he observed this phenomenon. He observed that as a purified mercury is cooled, what happens while doing the experiment? He observed that as a purified mercury is cooled, its resistivity vanished abruptly at 4.2 Kelvin. Students, when mercury is cooled, then what happens? Its resistivity completely vanished at 4.2 Kelvin. Above this temperature, the resistivity is small but finite. Okay, when the resistivity below this point is zero, so the temperature at which transition takes place, is called the critical temperature. Critical temperature or transition temperature. Okay, actually what happens, superconductivity was first discovered by the scientist Ohms. While doing the experiment, he observed that when mercury is cooled, its resistivity, what happens, it vanishes abruptly at 4.2 Kelvin. Above this temperature, resistivity is there, but it is small and it is finite. Okay, so the temperature at which the transition is takes place, this temperature is known as critical temperature or transition temperature. And students, critical temperature is the temperature at which the transition of a normal conductor to the superconducting state takes place. On cooling, the absence of the magnetic field, the above critical temperature, the substance is in normal state, but below TC it is in the superconducting state. Superconductivity is defined as the superconductivity is the state, it is marked by a sudden fall of the electrical resistivity of the material to nearly zero. When it is cooled to a sufficiently low temperature, a material which exhibits superconductivity is called superconductivity. So students, superconductivity is defined as the electrical resistivity of many materials and alloys drops suddenly to zero when the specimen is cooled to sufficiently low temperature. This phenomena is called superconductivity. This is the definition of superconductivity. Now we are going to discuss about nature of superconductivity using the free electron model. Here the resistivity of the metal may be written as resistivity of the metal is given by rho is equal to m divided by n e square tau, where m is the mass of the electron, e is the charge of the electron, and n be the number of electrons per unit volume, and tau be the collision time. So resistivity of the metal is defined by, is represented by rho, and it is given by m divided by n e square tau. So here the vibration of ion in a crystal decreases with the decreasing the temperature. So both are inversely proportional to each other. The vibration of the ion in a crystal decreases with the decreasing temperature. This has the effect of decreasing the probability of an electron ion collision or of increasing the collision time tau. Thus rho decreases as temperature is lowered. Both are directly proportional to each other. Thus the resistivity of a metal the resistivity of a metal should be tend to zero. As the temperature tend to zero, if tau becomes infinite at sufficiently low temperatures, then the resistivity vanishes entirely, which is observed in the superconductivity. Okay, students, superconductivity transition is reversible. Superconductivity transition is reversible means on heating, on heating the superconductivity sample, what happens? It recovered to its normal resistivity and becomes normal conductor at the temperature TC. Superconductivity occurs in a metallic elements like silver, lead, etc. And also in alloys and semiconductors. Superconductivity occurs in some metals like silver, lead, and it also occurs in alloys and semiconductor also. The range of transition temperature at present extends from 23.2 Kelvin for the alloy and it is 0.0 Kelvin for some conductors. Okay, this is the resistivity of the semiconductor. The next slide, in this slide I am going to explain the transition temperature. Already we have discussed the transition temperature. The temperature at which the transition from normal state to superconducting state takes place, normal state to superconducting states on cooling in the absence of the magnetic field, is called critical temperature or transition temperature. The transition temperature can be varied on adding the impurities of the superconducting elements. Transition temperature is different for different material. It depends upon the impurities which are added to the superconducting elements. The material which exhibit the superconductivity is called a superconductor. Superconductors are the material which exhibits the superconductivity phenomenon. The superconductor has a zero electrical resistance and conduct electricity without resistance. These are the some superconducting metals and alloys. And these are the some compounds are listed, and this is the transition temperature of the corresponding compounds. So now I am going to discuss about the properties of superconductor. First property is zero electrical resistance. Superconductors have zero electrical resistance below the transition temperature, and they can conduct electricity without resistance also. Zero electrical resistance means superconductors have zero electrical resistance. It means below the transition temperature they can conduct electricity without resistance. They can easily conduct the electricity without resistance. Next, Effect of magnetic field means below the transition temperature of a material, its superconductivity can be destroyed by the application of the strong magnetic field. So means below the transition temperature, material its superconductivity property of the superconductivity is destroyed by applying the strong magnetic field. effect of, if we apply strong magnetic field, then its superconductivity property vanishes in the material. Critical magnetic field. Critical magnetic field means the minimum magnetic field strength which destroys the superconducting property is known as critical magnetic field. If we apply the magnetic field, then what happens in the material? Superconductivity property vanishes. So this is the critical magnetic field. Critical current. Critical current means critical current, the minimum current which destroys the superconducting state of a superconductor. So if you apply some current, the value of the current, then it destroys the superconducting state of the material. Persistent current. Persistent current is the steady current which flows through the superconducting ring without any decreases in its strength is called persistent current. Okay, next is Meissner effect. The expulsion of the magnetic flux from the interior of a specimen below the transition temperature is called Meissner effect. Okay. These are the some properties of the superconducting material. Next is isotropic effect. The critical temperature of a superconductor varies with the isotropic mass. Thermodynamic effect. Thermal properties of the substances which changes under the superconducting states. So these are the few properties of the semiconductors. So in this session, we have discussed about the introduction to superconductors. What are superconductors, critical temperature or transition temperature, and some properties of the superconductors. So students, I am sure you know got the good understanding of the concept of superconductors. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Thank you.